Hi, my name is Stratos. In this video, we're going to see a way to connect any button in our website with a product from a WooCommerce plugin. So basically, if we want to add some tables or something else and we want to sell a service or we want to add a custom button and we want the visitor to click on the button and immediately a product or something else is added to the cart so he can pay for the services or whatever we want to sell. This idea came from a member in a forum that I am, and she asked for a way to do that. So it's a good idea for a video, and we're looking how it's done. So let's get started. We're going to use this pricing table, and let's start by adding this in our website. This website is an Astra theme and an Astra starter site template made with Elementor page builder. Okay, it's a pre-made template with some dummy products here. So let's go, and we're going to add the plugin for the tables. I will put the link in the description below for this particular pricing table. And let's go install it and activate it. Okay, once activated, I'm going to do two things. I'm going to start a new page. And also I'm going here that it says pricing table. And I will click add new table. Okay. These are the tables that are pre-made, the templates that are pre-made with the plugin. Okay, where you see Getting Pro, of course, it means that you must get the Pro version of this plugin. But let's go and check the free versions, and I will select this one. Okay, this is not a review about the plugin, it's just a way that we can connect anything with our products in the WooCommerce. So let's give a name to this table. I will call it table 1. Okay, and I will click save. Okay, so this is where I can edit and customize my pricing table. Okay, I can change the columns, I can change what it says here, I can change the colors and everything else. But I won't do any of those. I will take this code. This is the short code that I will put in my page. And I will go here that I have the pages. I will add new page. And then I'm going to create a page with Elementor and add a custom button and, of course, that table. So let's go and name test this page, test one. I will disable the title. Set no sidebar, full width stretched, and publish. Okay, this is Astra settings. If you don't have the Astra theme, you will not see these exactly settings. Okay, and let's edit with Elementor. I will also open the page in a new tab and how it's supposed to be in the front end. And let's go and see. Okay, so I will check this to create a new section, and I will drag in here a button. Okay, and this button will be named product 1. Product 1. Okay, of course you can name it what you want, you can put anything you want here, and you can customize the button as you can customize everything with Elementor. I will duplicate this and have it a product 2 underneath it. Product 2. Okay, update it, and let's see if we have those buttons in the front end. Okay, so product 1 and product 2. I don't care about the styling at this moment. And here I will drag another section and I will add a short code. Okay. And I will add my tables. apply. Update. And let's go and see in the front end how it looks. Okay, so we have two products here, two buttons here, and our table inside here. So what we want is here, we obviously want going to sell some services, and here we're going to sell some products. It doesn't matter what you're selling, you must create all of those in the WooCommerce. Okay, so let's go to the WooCommerce, that's the next step. I'm going to products and add a new product. And I'm going to show you how you will create a product. Okay, product name, name one or product one or something. Let's say product one. Okay, this is the description of the product. Now, it's better if you add the description in the tables also in the description of the product. Because if the visitor, what you have here, 10 user accounts, free third, all of those should be added in the description here. Because if a user will then go and see in the cart or in the orders of the WooCommerce what he have bought or what he have selected, he would see only this text, only this product, only the information that are in here, okay, not the tables. So add all of those information also here. Okay, so let's copy on one of those text. 10 user accounts, enter, free 30 trial, okay, of course, because it's not the same layout, this is text, you should add with this service, you will get 10 user accounts with the free 30-day trial, your money back, and all of those. This is a text area, okay, you should style it like a text, okay, then here, if you're going to sell a product, a virtual product, or a downloadable product, you will check accordingly. Here, this is a virtual product. Okay. So, if you see here, when I check virtual, the shipping has gone, because there is no shipping in virtual product, and it's not downloadable, because there is nothing to download. Okay, if it was a physical product, you leave this unchecked. I will add something as a regular price, 12. This is the category, plants, and of course we want a product image here. Okay, it's very important to add a product, to add an image on the product. After that, you can click publish. I will not click publish because, of course, I haven't styled anything. I haven't done anything with my products, but since this is a demo imported website, it has some products here. So I will use some of these. So let's go back to the pricing table. Okay, here I will go beneath that, it's the button here that says sign up. I will click here and here is the link. Now this is where I will put the link that replace the add to cart button. When you go to a product and you view the product, you have an add to cart button, and when you hit that, immediately this product will go up here in the cart. Okay, so when I click add to cart, this from 0 will become 1. And if I go here, I will see that this is the money plant, okay, and £20. So remove it, and we're good to go. What I will type here is the name of the domain at first. This is an HTTP website, it has no SSL. Okay, always use an SSL in a WooCommerce, but this is a demo site. So let's go and add our domain name, designweb.gr. After that, slash designweb.gr. You can copy it right here. Okay, after that, you will type question mark, add hyphen to hyphen cart, equals, and then the ID of the product. Now, how to find the ID of the product? If you go to products, you will see here that when you overlay a product, when you hover a product, you get the ID of the product. And if you go to edit of any of the product, you will get the ID here. Okay, the post. Post equals to 87. This is the ID of the product. Okay, this is the money plant. If I go back here, this is 87. This is the ID of my product. So let's go here and add 87. And that was all. I will click save. Save. Okay. And I will go to my test page. Sorry, this is the test page. I will refresh it. And hopefully, if I have done it everything well, when I click here that says sign up, I will get, as it says down left at my screen, I will get the ID to 87, the product with the ID 87 in my cart. So let's click sign up. And now I have this product. Okay, as you can see, I was also redirected in the front page of my site, and we will fix it. So this is what I have. Let's go and do it again. Let's go here again, refresh the page. I will click here to sign up. Sorry, I forgot to delete this. Okay, let's go again to my test page. So I have zero here. I will go click sign up. And I am redirected, and there is one product in my cart. Okay, now let's go back. I will disable this open link in a new window. Okay, I don't want this. And I will click save. Okay, let's go back. Here we are. I will refresh the page. Okay, I will delete those products. We have two products now in our cart. Delete all of those and let's go to the test page. And I will click again the first button that says sign up. So let's click sign up. And we have this one add to cart. Now let's go and fix our redirection. I will go back to my tables. I will click here that says sign up. Okay, link, of course. And then before the add to cart, I will input the name of the page that I want to be redirected at. So for me, it's test one. And of course, slash again. So this is the page that I want to be redirected, test one. I will click save. Okay, let's go to our test one page. Slash test one. And I'm going to click once again here that says sign up. So now we have one product to our cart. Now, if we want the visitor after the sign up goes directly to the cart or directly to the checkout page, we should redirect to those. And we're going to see how we can do that. Okay. Now, before that, let's go to our product page and we're going to add here also the same URL. Sorry, not free trial, but HTTP design. web.gr slash test one slash question mark add hyphen to hyphen cart equals, and let's get another product. I will take this one, 84. So here we're adding 84. Okay, and I will copy this and I will click the product number 2 and I will add, I thought I copied it, okay, copy, and I will add here the same, but I will change the ID of the product to add another product. So let's go and let's take this 52, go to the page, not here, here, 52, and update. So let's go to our test now, refresh it, and let's see if the products work. So we have two products here. I will add this one. And I will add also this. And I'm good to go. Okay. So delete all of those. And let's go back to, let's say, the Elementor. And instead of this test one, I will put the cart page cart. So basically it will redirect me to the cart. Of course, you have to name a page cart and set it as the cart page. Okay, if you go here that says WooCommerce, if you go here that says pages and all pages, you will see that my cart is named cart and my checkout page is named checkout. If there is something else with you, another page that is named instead of card, you have something else, you will put the name of the page. Okay, let's go and we'll add here the name card at button 2 as it seems. Okay, and button 1, we will rename this one with checkout. Checkout. Okay, I will click update and let's go and see if now it works. Okay, refresh the page. I have left this one here, so basically it added something to my cart. So let's go and test one. Okay, delete this. And I will copy this to have it in the clipboard and I will click here product one. So basically it will add the product and I will go straight to my checkout page. This is my checkout page. Okay. And let's go back to where we were, here. I will delete this product. And if I click the product number 2, the button number 2, I will be forward to the cart page. Okay, it's that simple. Now, be aware that if something doesn't work, you must go here that says WooCommerce settings. After that, you must go to products and here that says enable Ajax add to cart buttons on archives must be enabled. Okay, if you want with every adding to cart to be redirected to the cart, you should click here and there's no need to add the redirection yourself. Okay, this is for every product. So that was the video. I hope that I have helped with some questions. Okay, please subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up if you like the video, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye guys.